Hi, I'm Stu. Welcome back to another LumaFusion video tutorial. Today, I'm going to show you how I go about leveling up and straightening out videos in LumaFusion using a little grid that I have made. So let's get started. Okay, so I've got this little scenario set up whereby we have some special forces officers. Looks as if they're walking up a parking garage or something, and the camera goes behind a red pillar. The one thing that I've noticed is that the pillar itself is not straight, so I need to basically get that straightened up. One of the weaknesses of LumaFusion is that there's no options for guides or grids. Not that you want sort of Photoshop level guides or grids, but just something to help you straighten up your edges somewhat. So what I've done is I've created a little grid graphic, which you can see here. I just stretch it all the way along, and this will help me get the column nice and straight. The cool thing about this graphic is that you can just press one on your keyboard to get an in-frame and fit, and then just pinch and zoom outwards so that the boxes then appear a bit bigger while still keeping everything nice and straight. And then from there, we can highlight our clip below and then back into frame and fit. And I can then just use the rotation arrows to straighten things up. So if we look at this carefully, you can see that the edge is a little bit wider and leaning more towards the right at the top, and it's coming in at the bottom towards the left. So it's kind of rotating in a clockwise fashion. Now my guess is the person who did the video went for the back wall to try and get a level, and that's not something that we want to achieve. We're just going to tap on the degrees and then just play with the timeline just to see how well it's straightening up. It looks like a 1 degree shift is looking pretty good. Now you'll notice in the top left corner here, we're trimming or we're exposing a little bit of the video clip. So I'm just going to tap on the size and just scale into it a little bit so that we get the whole video clip again. And what this allows me to do is it gives me a nice clean straight edge to work to, which I can then composite and blend between the two video clips. So once you've done that and you're quite happy with your leveling grid, you can choose to either disable it or you can just delete it. You don't really need it. Now obviously when it comes to a leveling grid, I'll just bring it back in a second, you can use it for horizontals as well as verticals and just check that everything's nice and straight. And it can also be used when it comes to keyframe positioning to see if something's moving forwards or backwards within a frame by the way it interacts with the actual grid lines itself. What I've done is I've set up the leveling grid. It's just a simple PNG file, put it on my coffee page, and I'll put a link in the description below and you can download it for free, and it's my gift to you. Keep it tucked into your imported section in LumaFusion or in your Photos app, and then you can call upon it whenever you need it. Just drag and drop it onto the timeline that you're working on, and that's it. It's as simple as that.
If you like the video, then give it a thumbs up, as it really helps the channel. Don't forget to subscribe for more video tutorials every week, and ring the bell to get notified of when Stu has uploaded a new video tutorial. You have been watching. I am Stu. See you later.